I collected the 400 most useful prompts for ChatGPT. And in this video, I'm gonna share some of that invaluable knowledge. Let's have a look. I think it's not hard to agree on the fact that this tech is incredibly useful. But if you're anything like me, every time I tap into that little chat box, I think to myself, the potential of this thing seems endless. Maybe I'm not asking it the right questions or interacting with it correctly. So I set out onto a journey across the internet. I literally looked through all of the internet for the best ChatGPT prompts. Twitter, Discord, YouTube, blogs, man, I even went on Pinterest. And I myself tested every single prompt that seemed somewhat useful. Spoiler alert, most of the interesting ones don't even work anymore.
Yes, very sad. Anyway.
And once I found my favorite ones, I came up with a list of 100 ChatGPT prompts.
Aren't they just beautiful?
And that's essentially the ebook that we'll be looking at today. I sorted them into 5 categories. So without further ado, let me show you some of these. Okay, so in the productivity chapter, the focus is getting the most out of your time, essentially being more effective when it comes to managing your resources, like time and money. And I really wanted to share this particular prompt with all my YouTube subscribers because it's so damn useful. So look, can you find some practical ways to develop your coding skills without joining a course or community? Now all I gotta do is copy, paste, and by using this prompt, I essentially get advice from a seasoned professional that is trying to help me out with a new skill. I'm a firm believer of always adding new skills to your toolkit. And this prompt is a true superpower. It's hard to find trustworthy people on specific topics that will just give out quality advice like this for free. I'm still a beginner or maybe advanced beginner when it comes to coding, but let me tell you, this advice is worth gold when it comes to a beginner. And as you can see, I always broke it down. And this was actually the hardest part with the ebook. I always had to find a formula that you could replicate and customize to your own needs. So the way it works is simply you just replace the things in the square brackets with your own words. And then down here, you have some examples to get your imagination going. So for example, can you find some practical ways to improve your writing skills without joining a course or community? And here's my favorite part. You can simply take this formula and say, generate some examples that are relevant for a computer savvy young guy based on the following prompt formula. And then you post the formula and it just hits you with a bunch of prompts that are relevant to you. And if I say answer number one, it teaches me how to learn Photoshop myself. Like, come on, this is worth its weight in gold. So that was one of 100 prompts I have in that ebook. Okay, so I'll just go ahead and skip the copywriting category as I have a big video outlining multiple prompts from there. But just know there's over 30 pages like this just for copywriting. So yeah, you bet this ebook will help you with writing. Okay, so next up, I really want to look at the social category because that and the productivity category are my personal favorites. Look at this one on page 72. In Western society, is it generally considered better to be rich or powerful? An extremely hard question that has to consider so many variables. One might even call this an impossible question. And this is exactly one of those that you wouldn't just think of yourself. So let's see what it says here. And the answer is amazing. It actually starts talking about value systems, the thing that underlies this question, and how money or power might not be what most people value, and therefore none of the two is better. And then you can come at it with tricky questions like, but in the case of a politician, which one is preferable? Case of a politician, it is generally preferable to be powerful rather than wealthy. And then it explains. And you can use this particular prompt to travel the world, right? Just go ahead and say, in Indian culture, is it generally considered better to be traditional or modern? And ChatGPT starts schooling you on Indian culture right here, right now. Now, okay, this answer is very ambiguous, but with this, you can always follow up and specify a certain region or a certain city and then get more concrete answers. Powerful prompt, especially when you're dealing with a diverse group of people. But now it's time to talk about your health here, because this is, again, one of those that are not obvious at all. I mean, who would ask it, can you create a 7-day meal plan for an adult who needs to consume 2,000 calories a day, but make it lactose intolerance friendly? Extreme makeover. And again, as every time, you can customize it to yourself by changing the age group, the number of calories, and your restriction. Trust me, these formulas were really hard to generate, but it allows for a very no-brain approach to the whole thing. You can just go ahead, copy paste, and then by glancing over for a millisecond, you instantly see which word you need to change to customize the whole thing to your needs. So let's have a look. And yeah, by the way, the one in the line prompt is always my personal favorite one. And in this case, I just turned ChatGPT into a private chef that made a customized menu just for me. How amazing is that? Okay, and before I hit you with my favorite category to begin with in this ebook, which is entertainment, because it's just so fun to dive right in and try some prompts and have a quick laugh, I just want to address one obvious concern, and that is,
Igor, you just used ChatGPT to generate this thing and now you're trying to sell it?
Listen, ChatGPT is creative, but it has its limitations too. And trust me, it's not like I didn't try to use it in the process of creating this ebook. It's just when you come up with a useful prompt, turning that into a meaningful and understanding formula is a task you'll have to do manually. And not just that, I consulted all these prompts with other people and tested them multiple times. So these formulas have been reviewed for understandability and ease of use. Okay, and to round this out, we'll use one of my favorite entertainment prompts here. Let's say you got a new dog and you need a name for it, right? Now, instead of going about it the old school way, how about saying, can you come up with a funny nickname for a dog that incorporates a play on words? And look, I don't know what about it, but the keyword play on words is so effective in here. This never ceases to amaze me. Wolf Gangsta, Doggy Style, Pawsper, Bark Twain. Maybe it's just me, but the answers from this particular prompt, they're just really good. And that's the way I feel about so many of these. You get a total of 100 formulas, 400 prompts in total. So if you're interested, link is in the description. If not, I fully understand. I have my free weekly newsletter on AI and quality videos like this with more prompts, with a whole lot more coming.